morning, and welcome to St. Peter and All Saints Episcopal Church. Also, Merry Christmas. Deacon Donna and I and the whole congregation are happy to worship with you on this glorious day. A bulletin for this service can be found in a link in the description section of the YouTube video that you might have just clicked on, or in an email from the church. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you have poured upon us the new light of your incarnate word. Grant that this light, enkindled in our hearts, may shine forth in our lives, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My whole being shall exult in my God, for he hath clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness, as a bridegroom decks himself with a garland, and as a bride adorns herself with her jewels. For as the earth brings forth its shoots, and as a garden causes what is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring up before all the nations. For Zion's sake I will not keep silent, and for Jerusalem's sake I will not rest, until her vindication shines out like the dawn, and her salvation like a burning torch. The nations shall see your vindication, and all the kings your glory, and you shall be called by a new name that the mouth of the Lord will give. You shall be a crown of beauty in the hand of the Lord, and a royal diadem in the hand of your God. The word of the Lord. Let us read together Psalm 147. Hallelujah! How good it is to sing praises to our God! How pleasant it is to honor him with praise! The Lord rebuilds Jerusalem. He gathers the exiles of Israel. He heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. He counts the number of the stars and calls them all by their names. Great is our Lord and mighty in power. There is no limit to his wisdom. The Lord lifts up the lowly, but casts the wicked to the ground. Sing to the Lord with thanksgiving. Make music to our God upon the harp. He covers the heavens with clouds and prepares rain for the earth. He makes grass to grow up upon the mountain. He makes grass to grow upon the mountains and green plants to serve mankind. He provides food for the flocks and herds and for the ravens when they cry. He is not impressed by the might of a horse. He has no pleasure in the strength of a man. But the Lord has pleasure in those who fear him, in those who await his gracious favor. Worship the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion. For he has strengthened the bars of your gates. He has blessed your children within you. He has established peace on your borders. He satisfies you with the finest wheat. He sends out his command to the earth, and his word runs very swiftly. He gives snow like wool. He scatters hoarfrost like ashes. He scatters his hail like breadcrumbs. Who can stand against his cold? He sends forth his word and melts them. He blows with his wind, and the waters flow. He declares his word to Jacob, his statutes and his judgments to Israel. He has not done so to any other nation. To them he has not revealed his judgments. Hallelujah. The second reading for this Sunday is a reading from Paul's letter to the Galatians. Now before faith came, we were imprisoned and guarded under the law, until faith would be revealed. Therefore the law was our disciplinarian until Christ came, so that we might be justified by faith. But now that faith has come, we are no longer subject to a disciplinarian. But when the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, in order to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive adoption as children. And because you are children, God has sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a child. And if a child, then also heir and heir through God, the word of the Lord.
Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life. And the life was the light of all the people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. John testified to him and cried out, "This was he of whom I said, 'He comes, he who comes after me ranks ahead of me, because he was before me.' From his fullness we have all received grace upon grace. The law indeed was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. It is God, the only Son, who is close to the Father's heart, who has made him known." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ. If you have been to this building or driven by, you may have noticed that our monument sign out front has a panel for readily changeable copy, meaning that the preacher can put the title of his sermon on the sign for all of the drivers and walkers to see. Now, we've all seen pithy sayings on other signs in front of other churches. What if the title of today's sermon here was "Sinners in the Hands of an Angry God"? I suspect that attendance would be down. Some people who drove up might have simply turned around and gone straight to breakfast. That is the title of a sermon preached by Jonathan Edwards in Connecticut in the mid-1700s. I mention it because of the tremendous contrast it makes with this passage from St. Paul's letter to the Galatians, in which the Spirit in our heart cries to God, "Abba, Father." Abba is the Aramaic word for father, but it's more intimate, more like daddy. So one way of characterizing our relationship with God is to cry, "Daddy." Another way is to cower before the angry deity and try hard to avoid the punishment from which, according to Edwards, we have been only temporarily spared. But I think that St. Paul hit the mark when he said, "Abba." In the garden, Jesus prayed to the Father and used this word. In Israel, I heard a little boy running after his father saying, "Abba, Abba, 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 Abba." Paul said that God sent his Son, born of a woman, in order to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive adoption as children. God came to us in the flesh, in the person of Jesus Christ. How intimate is that for the deity to become one of us? How full of love God must be to take on our flesh and suffer our lives and die our death. And indeed, we are adopted as God's children and made heirs with Christ. I would not be at all surprised to learn that God is sometimes quite angry with us. Good parents get angry for good cause. But Christmas, properly called the Feast of the Incarnation, reminds me that God is full of love for us, indescribably intimate in relationship with us, a good parent who desires only good things for these children. Perhaps I should put the title of this sermon on the sign out front: Our Heart's Cry, Daddy, Father. Come, celebrate Christmas in the hands of our loving God.
Devoted people. gathered all as one. He lay in a manger instead of a bed. Noel loved they, Noel chantons ici. Soon the kings led by, a bright and shining, star. Came from all the places and lands so far, bringing their gifts, bubble and incense red.
Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. And his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church.
That we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons. For Michael, our presiding bishop, Diane, our bishop provisional, and our clergy, Father Jonathan and Deacon Donna, our vestry, our day school, our parish staff, and especially St. Mark's Episcopal Church in Kimberling City.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world, especially Joe, our president, our elected representatives, and the courts.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble, especially those affected by the recent tornadoes and by the coronavirus. Mary Elizabeth Bradley, Ed Dwyer, Kevin Feingold, Dorothy Gregory, John Thompson, and also Catherine Allberg, the Reverend Barbara Beam, Craig Cartwright, Kathleen Clark, Lisa Cole, Alan and Christy Aiken and family, Alex and Susan Green, Jennifer Brown Harnick, Betty Lockhart Hayes, Jim, Ed and Blair Joyner Jr., Charles and Karen Joyner, Michael and Martha Kelly, Glenn and Ruby Lane, Susan Malone, Jeannie McDowell, Kathy Morris, Deacon Bob Murphy, Bob Knoll, Gary Oda, Rosemary Overby, Pam, Lawrence Presley, Rob, Tom Carley and Theo Roberton, Dick Strong, Carolyn Watson, Don and Donna White, the Reverend Stephen Wilson, and all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest, especially Michael Cartwright.
Let light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others, for those serving in the military and their families, especially Loyal Otterson, Alex Battle, Tanner Bosch, Matthew Carmichael, Gage Dietz, Brendan Frederick, Tom Gildea, Ryan Kelly, Trey Mavers, Robert Mangold, Lucy Nix, Sean Perrone, Samantha and Clint Hubbard, Dan Sanford, Hunter Soule, and those who are celebrating birthdays and anniversaries, Jeff and Tammy Anderson, Betty Cross, Ruth Franklin, Ron and Helena Fultz, Bob Palmer.
O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us pray as our Savior has taught us, saying, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and remain with you always.
Amen. Let us go forth in the name of Christ.
Thanks be to God.